These are the mountains. This is a subalpine desert. This climate that you are about to enter. Here are a few simple tips for surviving in this rugged country.
First of all, the shelter. Even though ours is built in a ditch, any location with two trees spaced and a good pole distance apart will work. First, you rig your main pole. Depending on the size of your tarpaulin, this ought to be from 10 to 15 feet long. Next, your tarpaulin. Ours is very large. Bring it out with the camouflage side out. You'll want to spread this across the pole. On the near corner, fasten the hole with your rope. This is your shorter piece of rope, not the long piece. All the top holes come with these holes installed at various intervals. Run one loop around a knot, bring the other one up and under. Bring it back around the knot, come underneath and tie it.
It should look like this once it's been tied.
Now run the rope at a correct angle down to the far corner. Make sure you fasten this rope where it can be accessed easily, for it will be removed later. Run it through in a loop, the second to the side hole in the corner on the side that you started with. Now bend them through and bring the rope around like that. This creates a very tight hitch. Once you've done that, find your other piece of rope. Your other piece of rope is longer and there's a lot more of it. The same thing you just did at the corner up here, only this time we'll be securing it with the longer rope and removing the shorter one as we go. The short rope just holds it in place. You can omit the short rope altogether, but having it in place helps the process to be easier done.
Done the little rope, hold the loop in place while the big rope passes through it. Now, make a double bend on the corner and run the rope line through it. This will create the base for your knot. Take another loop and drop that over the protruding point of your knot. Now, take one quick loop all the way around the log. So that there is one wrap of rope around it. It should look like this. It should look like this when you are done.
Now take the long rope that you fastened and run it out the same hole that your small rope is in, while removing the small rope at the same time. When you run it through this hole, you'll want to take a double loop. at the correct tarp distance and width. At the correct tarp distance, pull the pull rope taut. Then bring the loose end of your rope around from underneath and take it out the back side. Simply enough. Having accomplished this, you will bring your double loop until the tarp is taut in the corners. Be careful not to let your rope be fouled by branches. Pull out until the rope has reached a complete distance. Next, you will need your knife. Carve yourself a peg from wood, making sure that it has a point on one end with little notches to hold it into the ground securely and a small notch on the back end through which the rope can grab. Either press or drive your stake into the ground with a flat rock. Next, run the rope around the stake at the bottom, again at the middle, and again through your notch. In all, you should have 3 or 4 loops. Now, run the rope up to your tarp. Pick up the next pole and run the rope through it. If in a situation where that doesn't appear to be pulling enough on the tarp, you can bring the rope back around the bottom of the stake, make a wrap under the very bottom line and over the top line. Pull them together taut, put 3 or 4 wraps on them, and bring the line around the back of the stake and up to the front. You will now be able to pull a third line in like this. Do that twice and you will have a securely fastened stake. Keep the excess rope out of the way where you will not trip on it. And remember, when you carve the stake, that knives can be dangerous. Once you have succeeded in this step, you're ready to lay out a mattress in your new shelter.